The state wants to protect its hegemony. And when there's people who are challenging that, I see the state coming down on people very hard. But there's also the positive side that we have the Constitution, where these rights are protected. But now it's not just the Constitution that's going to make sure that their rights are protected. People have to do something about that.
Me doy cuenta que en los últimos años uno o la sociedad o los movimientos sociales están adquiriendo una etapa de información, ¿verdad? Creo que las siguientes etapas serán de organización y de movilización.
It's evolving to a situation where the constitutional order, as it is currently constituted, gives more power to individuals and communities to participate in processes, be they political, social, or economic processes, through the legal route.
Yo esperaría que el movimiento de derechos humanos esté cada vez más articulado hacia enfrentar estos nuevos retos.
I can actually see huge people's movements against mines, against damming, a lot of the development projects. And strangely, the climate is such that the Supreme Court, as well as the legislature, are actually reacting to it.
People are now more aware of their rights, so people are agitating more about their rights. People want to demonstrate more, people want to go to the streets more to let their voice be heard.
Los derechos humanos van a ser un ecosistema con diferentes seres, organizaciones que cumplen diferentes funciones y ya no más una monocultura, donde había una sola organización, un solo tipo de organización, que era la ONG de derechos humanos clásica.
There's a lot of struggle and resistance, which is good.